In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install Magic Thumb in Dreamweaver. Not only does Magic Thumb enlarge small images to full screen, you can also have captions, navigational arrows to browse images without returning to the page, and also links too. To get started, I'm going to download the demo file on the product page and save it to my computer, then extract all the files. The Magic Thumb folder is the folder I need. I'm working locally on my computer, so I'll copy this and save it here. You'll need to upload the Magic Thumb folder to your server. Within the folder, there are CSS and JavaScript files, which I'll be referencing soon in my head HTML code. Go back to the Magic Thumb product page and click the integration link on the left-hand side. Scroll down to the installation section. If you have no code in your HTML file, then copy all the code provided. I already have some, so I'm just going to copy the script and link rel attribute of the head section and paste it into the head section of my file. I'm using Dreamweaver MX for this example. I'll just tidy up my code a bit. You can see the CSS and JavaScript files are referenced in the head code. If you move the files out of the Magic Thumb folder for any reason, remember to update the location references here in the head section, otherwise Magic Thumb won't work. Now we can go back to the integration page, and this time I'll copy the body code and paste it into the body section of my HTML file. The href reference is my large image, which will be the enlarge expanded effect. There's the Magic Thumb class, and the image source is a small image that will appear on my web page. I've saved my images in an images folder, so I'm just going to reference that too. Now, if I preview my page, you can see Magic Thumb is working. You'll notice the navigation arrows haven't appeared on the enlarge effect. This is because I'm only using one image. As soon as you add a second image, the arrows will automatically appear. Now that Magic Thumb is installed, I'm going to make a couple of changes. First, I'm going to change the expand effect from a smooth linear effect to a bounce effect. Then I'll add a background colour to the enlarge effect. To do this, we need to go back to the integration page. You'll notice we have anchor links at the top. This is to make it easier to navigate around the page. Click the number 6 effect option. There are other options you can choose from, as well as bounce and linear, which I'm highlighting here. In the example code, copy the rel attribute expand effect and paste it after the Magic Thumb class. Where bounce is shown, you can enter any of the other options I've just highlighted in the last step. Next, I'm going to use the code in the background section. By default, the background colour is grey, so if you want to keep this, copy the rel attribute background opacity, which will allow the grey to be seen. I want to change the colour, so I'll use the code below. I don't want to change the speed, so I won't copy this code. But if you do, you'll need to copy this code too. I already have the rel text in my code, so I'm just going to copy it from background opacity and enter a semicolon after bounce, then paste my new background code. The opacity is set to 80. I'm going to change this to 60. And I want the colour to be red. Now with a preview, you can see my expand effect is no longer linear. It's bounce, and my background colour is now red. If you're not sure how you want to display your images, go to our Magic Thumb examples page. It's full of great ideas, from multiple images of a product to repositioning your caption and inserting images in it too. All the HTML code for examples and more can be found on the integration page. At the top of each page on our website, there's a Contact Us link. If you have any questions about Magic Thumb or any of our other tools, just get in touch. If we're not online when you send your message through, We'll get back to you the very next day. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. Thanks for watching.